I was born in Fort Worth, Texas, and my father was a traveling salesman with the Waples Platter Grocery Company, and went to Texas Tech University. And in the meantime, I joined the Marine Reserve. And when I finished college with a degree in geology, and the Marine Corps called me, sent me to Quantico and Camp Pendleton, California, and from there to Korea as a platoon commander.
George O'Brien was in charge of a rifle platoon in the 7th Marines that was one of many defending the 38th parallel in Korea. On October 27, 1952, a numerically superior communist Chinese force overran a Marine company that held a strategic hill in an area known as the Hook. O'Brien's company was waiting in reserve when the order came down to retake the hill the following day.
We'd just been relieved off the line, and we were in battalion reserve at that time. It was chilly. We were there for 8 or 10 hours just waiting. And I had asked for coffee for my troops because it was chilly and they didn't have cover. They came up with some trucks with, I thought they were going to get coffee, but they were passing out grenades. And that was a little shock. You think you're going to have ease the company. And they moved us up as far as they could with the trucks. And we marched the rest of the way up to what was, at that time, the MLR that had been overrun. And there was no trench line there. It had been completely wiped out with bombs and mortars and artillery. And there were several straggling troops there. And I commandeered as many as I could to go with me. We were taking artillery, mortars, heavy weapons fire. And I was anxious for us to get out of that position and move toward our objective. I was losing kids while they were there. And of course, it was very upsetting. I just stopped and asked the good Lord to give me the courage and the intelligence to guide those troops as they should be led.
O'Brien jumped up, shouting for his men to follow, and led a fearless assault directly into an exposed area under heavy enemy fire. Just before reaching the enemy's entrenchment, he was shot in the arm and knocked down. Regaining his footing, he charged the enemy's bunkers, hurling hand grenades and following that with his rifle. For 4 hours, he continued to lead his men and evacuate the wounded. Upon relief by another company, O'Brien refused medical attention, personally making sure that none of his wounded were left behind. His leadership and bravery were instrumental in the recapturing of this vital position.
We moved in on our objective. We took it. And I lost a lot of kids. I didn't know their name. When we were coming into San Francisco Harbor, one of my friends, they picked up the radio from San Francisco, and he told me, he said, "George, we just heard over the radio that you are going to receive the Medal of Honor." There was 8 of us, I believe, at that time. Met in Washington, D.C., and President Eisenhower gave us all the medal. Combat took place on the 27th of October, and 1 year later, he gave me this medal on the 27th of October. I repeat this as if it were rote. But this medal's not mine. It belongs to those kids who never grew up to be grandfathers. I just hold it in trust. It's in trust. And I hope I wear it well. I pray.